Good day, class. Welcome to our subject, Civil Engineering Laws. Today, we will be discussing the introduction, basically the first part of the 1987 Constitution, specifically Article 1. You see, class, we will not be discussing the preamble anymore because naaral yun na yun. Okay? So, alam ko na during your elementary years or senior high school years, naituro na siya, naipakabisa siguro ng teacher nyo, and we do not want to dwell on that. Yes, the preamble is important, but then, from the term itself, preamble meaning before you walk, no? Before you walk. So it just serves as an introductory part of the Constitution. Thus, it is more fitting for us to discuss the national territory, or particularly the Article 1 of the 1987 Constitution, and how it is applied, or how can we relate to it, to our discipline, to our practice. And also, I'll be giving insight also with Article 2, Declaration of State, Declaration of Principles and State Policies, Section 15. So, let's start. Allow me to share my screen. Okay. Now, I want you guys to memorize this by. Okay, memorize this by. Because it will give us an insight of the territorial jurisdiction of our country. And especially if you plan to be in the environment practice, in the water practice, it will be an edge for you once you are aware how are we governing our territorial waters. Okay? So, let's start. The national territory, it is stated here, the national territory comprises the Philippine archipelago. That's the first word of insight. Okay? The Philippine archipelago. No question. What does an archipelago means? Probably before you have been, we have an idea that archipelago literally means a group of islands surrounded by water. Well, that is a fallacy. Okay? Group of islands, first of all, wala ka namang isla, class, nang walang tubig. Di ba na hindi napapalibutan ng tubig? So, we will derive definition based on the principle of the first mention. And one of the oldest Bible, one of the oldest books in the world, class, or probably the oldest, no, is the Bible. And interestingly, the Bible has this term called, or this study called, principle of the first mention. Meaning, you can trace back the meaning of its word based on its first mention, the time that it was first mentioned. For example, parang di mo makalimutan, di ba, na pag sinabi sa'yo ng crush mo na gusto ka rin niya, di ba? Pag sinabi niya sa'yo, di mo makalimutan niya. So, ganun din dito. Di ba? Pag sinabi sa Bible, tinitrace back yon. Sometimes, sa etymology niya, sa pinagmulan. For example, sa Old Testament, it was written originally in the Hebrew language. And yung New Testament, nagkaroon na ng same language, no? Kaya the time was right when Jesus Christ came, no? Common na yung language, the Greek language. Now, so pag-usapan natin, ano nga ba yung pinagmulan ng archipelago? It came from the Greek word meaning archon. O, sino yung mga nagdodota dyan? Okay. Meaning, the seas. Ay, mali. That literally means chief or leader. And the meaning of Pelagos is the sea. This. So, ibig sabihin, pag literal mo translate last, chief sea. Tama ba? Meaning, it pertains to the water. So, bakit land tayo ng land? Group of islands, di ba? Mas hina-highlight yun yan. So, you would say that the archipelago literally means that it literally means that archipelago wala. Archipelago means a large body of water or body of water surrounded by islands. A pwedeng group of islands if you want to be more technical. But that would suffice it. We want to pertain to the waters. Okay? Now, let's talk about with all the islands and waters embracery. Mamaya na tayo mag-usap sa lands, no? Sa islands. Pag-usapan natin, guys, ito. Kasi when we mention the waters, when we mention the waters, tingnan nyo yung last sentence. Pwede tayong tumalun dito, di ba? The waters. You know. So from here, tatalun tayo dito. Bakit ganito tumalun? Hindi ko makita yung ano. Yan. Diameter ba? Ito napapalitan. Laser pointer na lang. Ayan. So the waters, embrace therein, and we're not skip tayo sa last part. Sabi dito, class, the waters around, between, and connecting the islands of the archipelago, regardless of their breadth and dimension, form part of the internal waters of the Philippines. Ibig sabihin nito, class, this last sentence is what we call the archipelagic doctrine. Take note. Archipelagic doctrine. Yan yun. When we talk about the waters, syempre, you are talking about territorial jurisdiction. Ang common issue dito, kanino ba talaga mapupunta ang South China Sea? Or sa atin ba talaga ang West Philippine Sea? Tama ba? Kasi when you talk about the waters, international yung labanan. Tama ba? Kaya babalik ako sa question ko sa inyo. Naalala nyo ba kung kailan nagsimula ang United Nations? Ito, itong lanyard ko ngayon, Sustainable Development Goals. It started when people have decided after the World War II, 1940s. When they decided that they don't want anymore this type of bombings. Ayaw na nila ng ganitong mga gera. No, ayaw na nila ng kaguluhan. They want unity. Kaya nga United Nations eh. Di ba? Nagkakaisa mga bansa. And never again, such genocide, such murders will happen again. Hindi na natin tatanggapin yun sa ating panahon ngayon. Kaya nagkaroon ng international government organization called the United Nations. And dahil international yung jurisdiction nila, this convention stated or gave our right are the, called the United Nations Convention on the Laws of the Sea, or commonly known as Convention on the Laws of the Seas. Sorry. Or commonly known as UNCLOS, na kung saan nagpadala tayo ng several of our best senators during that, led by Senator Arturo Tarantino. And ito yung naging commitment natin. The archipelagic doctrine. Okay? And under the UNCLOS class, nagkaroon ng magdodrawing ako ha. Mahabang gawin. Discard. Nagay tayo na isa pang share screen ulit. Boom! Under the unclosed class, meron tayong tinatawag na baseline slope. Okay? Imagine this, we are looking on a plan view. We are looking on a plan. And take note, this is not drawn to scale. Okay. And this, I would say this is your beach. No? This is your this is your shoreline. Okay. And then this is your beach, your coastal mga rest house, no? Mga beach house. And under ano to? Principles of coastal engineering, kailangan mo ng clearance about 100 meters. Okay. Again, not drawn to scale. Now, under the unclosed class, meron tayong tinatawag na baseline slope. Ulitin natin. No? Baseline slope. And the baseline slope states ano ba yung baseline? It basically states, class, that the low water mark. Ano ibig sabihin sa ng low water mark? The low water mark level. Ito, class, yung linya from the term low kapag low tide. Low tide, dito nagtatagpo yung linya ng shore, mga buhangin, sa dagat. Okay? That is what we mean by the low water mark level. Now, during that time, the baseline, bibilang ka ng 12 nautical miles. And doon nakapaloob, class, ang tinatawag natin. Ah, by the way, this is your sea, no? Usap tayo ng usap, eh. Ito yung beach mo. Patubig to. Plan B, ha? Ito na yung iyong territorial waters. Take note, class. Bakit kaya tinawag siyang nautical miles? Una-una, yun ang basihan ng measurement sa karagatan. Okay? Not in nautical miles. Pangalawa, oh, sir, bakit hindi tayo nag-system international? Yun naman yung ano natin. Common units. Di ba? Hindi natin gagamitin yun kasi tandaan nyo, this is international affair. This is an international convention. Ano mas gusto mo? May decimal. Ano mas mahirap basahin? May decimal o wala? Ano mas magandang basahin? May decimal, wala? Wala, di ba? When you have fixed the number as 12 nautical miles, lahat ng bansa adhere to this. Okay? Now, bibilang ulit tayo from the territorial waters. Ah, by the way, the territorial waters, everything we can enjoy in this area. No? We have all sovereignty, exploration, development, and utilization nandoon. Okay? Ngayon, bibilang ulit tayo, class, ng 12 nautical miles from the territorial waters and we will have the contiguous zone. Sorry, not scaled, no? This is what we'll have now, the contiguous zone. Dito, class, andito pa rin ang ating jurisdiction and tandaan nyo, may mga pagkakataon na dahil international waters yan, pwedeng may dumaang barko. Eh, paano kung yung dumaang barko na yon may sakay na marijuana, may baong mga shabu, mayroong mga illegal firearms. Diba? Babawal yun. So, meron tayong ano dito, autonomy, security, fiscal din, kaperahan sa mga smuggling ng pera. We can we have the jurisdiction to try those case. Pwede tayo mag kaso sa mga ganun, no? Okay? And then finally, ito yung pinakamahal. 200, no? 200 nautical miles from the low water mark. Ito na yung tinatawag natin. Exclusive economic zone. Okay? So we can, in the exclusive economic zone class, we can enjoy all the right again. In exploration, development, utilization of marine resources. Now, the question is this. Homework niyo siguro to. You have to discover if in the baselines, kayo yung maghanap ng pinakamalapit, malapit na 200 nautical miles na mag-a-approach sa West Philippine Sea. 200 nautical miles from this area. Ah, by the way, 200 nautical miles, ito, whole number na rin. That is equivalent to 360 kilometers. Okay? Approximately. So gusto natin na sa atin pa ba yung West Philippine Sea? Tama ba? 200 nautical miles or sa China pa rin? I-figure out nyo, no? Kasi yung reality ganito, class. Nasa kanila yung ancestral right. Panahon pa lang ng mga dynasty. Tama ba? They are powerful enough to have the power to maintain or to explore this. They have the resources to explore, to develop marine resources. Nangingisda, lahat na nasa kanila. They have the capacity in China. Ito yung clincher. Pumirma rin sila doon sa UNCLOS. So, ang question, pasok din sila sa baselines doon. Ngayon, from their land, from their low water mark level, bibilang tayo ngayon 200 nautical miles. Kanino mapupunta? Si South China Sea o si West Philippines? So, that's the first part one for this quick introductory video for the national territory. I'll be uploading part two in a moment.